Good morning. Three states of matter. Here we go.
Flippin' physics.
In front of me, you can see the three most common states or phases of matter on Earth.
Isn't that just a beaker with water in it?
Yeah, but it still shows three states of matter.
The beaker is a solid, the water is a liquid, and the air inside and outside the beaker is a gas.
Right.
Exactly, Bobby. Thanks. But I get that it is more clear if I use three different objects. This hockey puck is a solid, the water in this beaker is a liquid, and the air in this beaker is a gas. Solid, liquid, gas. Let's make a table to identify the differences between these three states of matter, starting with whether or not they have a fixed shape. A solid has a fixed shape, whereas liquids and gases do not have fixed shapes. You can see that when I apply forces trying to change the shape of the hockey puck, that does not change the shape of the hockey puck. However, I can change the shape of the water just by pouring it into a different container. With regards to the air in the beaker, which is a gas, you know what? Let's pour the water back into the beaker and use the air inside the bottle as our example of a gas instead. Hopefully you can see that I can change the shape of the air inside the bottle just by squeezing the bottle and changing the shape of the bottle, which contains the air.
But I can change the shape of this rubber ball by squeezing it. So, is this rubber ball a solid or a liquid?
Okay, so we are talking about the most basic principles of these three states of matter. So, when we say solid, what we really mean is a rigid solid. Most solids do have some elasticity, meaning they can be deformed slightly, however they return back to their original shape.
Sure. At this point, we are assuming all solids are rigid and do not change shape.
What is a fluid?
A fluid is a substance that tends to flow to form the shape of its container.
So, a liquid or a gas?
Yeah.
Right. Fluid is a term which refers to liquids or gases. The next line in our table identifies if the state of matter has a fixed volume. Solids have a fixed volume. For example, when I place the hockey puck into a beaker, it does not take the shape of the beaker because it is a solid, and solids do not change shape or volume. However, when I pour the water back into the bottle, the water does take on the shape of the bottle, but it does not completely fill the bottle because the volume of the water, which is a liquid, does not change. And the air inside the plastic bottle changes both shape and volume as I squeeze it, because air, which is a gas, changes shape and volume to conform to the shape and volume of the container which the gas is contained in.
But why?
What do you mean, Bobby?
Why do the different states of matter behave differently?
You know what? That is a fair question. It comes down to the behavior of the extremely tiny particles which make up matter. For our purposes today, we will use the term particles and not worry about whether they are atoms or if they are molecules which are composed of atoms.
Oh, right. All matter is made up of tiny particles that are moving around.
Atoms are made of protons, neutrons, and electrons, right?
And protons and neutrons are made of quarks?
What are quarks made of?
Right, so none of that is what this lesson is about, which is why, for right now, we are just going to call the tiny objects all matter is made of particles.
Okay.
Sure.
Different states of matter have tiny particles which behave in different ways. For example, the distance between particles in a solid is small, the distance between particles in a gas is large, and the distance between particles in a liquid is typically almost as small as in a solid, H2O being an exception. and the tiny particles which make up matter are attracted to one another. In a solid, the force of attraction is large. In a gas, the force of attraction is small. And in a liquid, the force of attraction is, again, somewhere in between or medium. And the tiny particles are moving, which means they have kinetic energy. In a solid, the kinetic energy of the particles is small. In a gas, the kinetic energy of the particles is large. And in a liquid, the kinetic energy of the particles is medium.
Kinetic energy is the energy of motion, so the particles in solids are moving slowly, the particles in gases are moving quickly, and the particles in liquids are moving at some sort of medium speed?
That is correct, Billy. Now, I do want to point out that temperature and pressure affect the state of matter. For example, dihydrogen monoxide, or H2O, at atmospheric pressure and temperatures below 32 degrees Fahrenheit or 0 degrees Celsius is in its solid state, which we call ice. This H2O is currently at negative 18 degrees Celsius or roughly 0 degrees Fahrenheit, which means it starts out as entirely ice. As thermal energy is added to the ice, the forces of attraction holding the particles together in the solid break and become the slightly weaker forces of attraction in the water, which is a liquid. H2O at atmospheric pressure and this temperature is in its liquid state, which we call, again, water. And as thermal energy continues to be added to the water, again, the forces of attraction holding the particles together break and become even weaker forces of attraction in water vapor, which is a gas. And H2O at the atmospheric pressure and temperatures above 212 degrees Fahrenheit or 100 degrees Celsius is in its gaseous state, which we call water vapor. I hope you enjoyed learning about these three common states of matter. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Aren't there other states of matter as well, like plasma, which is a really, really hot state of matter?
And Bose-Einstein condensate, which is a really, really cold state of matter.
I bet Mr. P only wanted to talk about those three states of matter because those are the three most common states or phases of matter on Earth, where most of us live.
Most of us?
Yeah.